good. Thank you for talking to
welcome,
me today.
Welcome. Yeah, good to see you.
Great to be back.
Yeah, it's good.
This is just really an opportunity for me to ask you some questions so that my constituents back home get a sense of what the heck I'm doing on the Ag Committee and what the Farm Show is, because, you know, I represent Northwest Philadelphia, a largely urban district, and a lot of folks haven't been to the Farm Show. So tell me about the Farm Show itself.
Well, I think the Farm Show has a great history. 103 years we've done this, right? And it started out when, you think 100 years ago, this was an agricultural economy, it was an agrarian state. That obviously has changed, but food and agriculture have really retained importance in PA, right? Not just from a social aspect, but certainly from an economic standpoint. So if you're in Philadelphia, you know, your constituents like to eat as we do.
Every day,
three times a day, preferred, right?
Yes.
Well, how does that happen, right? And that's what the Farm Show is about, telling the story. Who produces it, how do we do it, technology, the products, all of that's found at the Farm Show.
So how big is it?
You have, 200 and, we've got about 24 acres, I'll put it that way.
Maybe 24
that's acres. 24 acres, all under roof. And you get your food courts and Christmas trees and livestock and everything in between.
So yesterday I posted on Instagram a picture of my meal.
Yes.
Which of course include the legendary milkshakes, pulled pork, turkey chili. Oh my goodness, it was an extravaganza.
Yeah.
Now, my neighbors are asking me if I'm going to get some vegetables today.
Maybe. Yeah, the question is whether they're fresh or deep fried.
But. Right, exactly. And on the way here, I walked by some alpaca.
Yeah.
When we talk about the diversity of agriculture, I mean, it's pretty expansive in Pennsylvania. What are kind of some of the highlights of the things you're most proud of that a lot of people may not know about?
Well, I think you mentioned alpacas, right? It's a great, great fiber. The alpaca, that's what they're produced for, right? We have industrial hemp here at the Farm Show, a new crop, a new old crop,
right?
Because it was here for,
centuries,
right. And it's important to Pennsylvania. If you take a look at the Christmas trees, which are just beyond us here, look at the new varieties of trees, and, they're breeding those to be green and fresh and, insect resistant.
Wow.
The apples behind us, are great varieties, fresh market varieties.
Yeah, when I was growing up, we didn't have a range of apples like my kids have today. It's
right. It's
pretty amazing, just in terms of the sheer diversity of things.
Yeah.
I actually have in my district a goat project where they have goats who recycle, they eat Christmas trees and poison ivy.
Wow.
So
that's being entrepreneurial.
It's very entrepreneurial, yes. So back to hemp. You'd mentioned hemp, and I know that in the federal farm bill, they essentially legalized hemp, which had been prohibited because it was considered cannabis, which is associated with the marijuana.
Right.
And so that's a major change. How will that impact the state of Pennsylvania?
Well, we've had a pilot program for 2 years, right? And I think I've learned a lot about a crop. The challenge we have is that for nearly 75 years, the U.S. government said it's prohibited, as you noted, right? So you think about the advancements of anything when it's taken 75 years off.
Right.
Right? We're starting over in many respects. But that said, I mean, we finally have a green light to produce it here, to process it here, to sell it here. So I think it has great potential for Pennsylvania. We know how to produce things. Now we need to develop that sort of research for the new products that, I've heard about the advanced manufacturing and fiber technology, right? The oils that are used in both human and medicinal purposes.
Right.
It's animal feed, it's construction materials. There's endless possibilities, and at a time when, we're really looking at economic opportunity. If we can reintroduce a crop to Pennsylvania farmers and consumers, it's a great thing.
That's awesome. Something else I heard, it's about farm to table. Here there's some stats that put Pennsylvania like top of the list in terms of states across the country that have a farm to table high profile.
Yeah. Well, we do, and we're second in the nation in organic sales. A lot of that's coming out of farm markets and farm to table and the CSAs and PA.
Now let people know what CSAs are.
Yeah, so it's a community supported agriculture. I like to call them sort of agriculture supported communities.
Okay.
Right? Just turn it around.
Right.
The point is, it's CSA or ASC. Mm-hmm. It's really important because it connects people in the local neighborhoods with agriculture production, and in some cases provides a great opportunity for workforce. In some areas, you've got some great opportunities.
Yeah, absolutely.
Amazing.
My district.
Yeah, your district doing a great job.
And we met shortly after I got in the office at Saul High School, which is one of only two high schools of its kind in the country that is agriculture focused, right?
That's correct. So there are other ag science and FFA programs in the PA and across the nation. But you, in your district at Saul and a school in Chicago, had the distinct honor of being like number one and two. You're the largest in the east of Mississippi of their agricultural science and their FFA program. It's a great honor.
So what is the connection between kind of urban existence and agriculture? We talk a lot about STEM and public education. What's the connection between STEM and agriculture?
Yeah. Well, if you think about agriculture, it's a science, right? It's about, you know, genetics, it's about technology, it's the drones, it's the manufacturing, however you want to describe it, it begins with production, but the production has to have, you know, some traits and characteristics, and so we put a real emphasis on that in the department to talk about agriculture and the jobs, but also the STEM jobs that, you know, folks ought to be thinking about, right? It's supply chain, it's genetics, it's veterinary science, it's the technology platforms by which, you know, products move and how they arrive at your front door or mine, right? That's all part of this food and agriculture conversation.
And there's a lot of growth opportunities, a lot of jobs that are out there for folks who are interested. So in many respects, we have an opportunity to promote agriculture in cities.
Right. And then what we want to do at the farm show really is very simply is to have people appreciate agriculture and food. But also we hope it sort of spawns some thought about, how did that happen?
Right.
I mean, who does that? I mean, what's the opportunity? And that's zip code neutral, right?
Right.
The folks who are really good at code development for supply chain, that has nothing to do with whether they're in agriculture today or live in a rural area or urban, suburban area. Having them think about food and ag as a meaningful place for employment is part of our conversation this week at the Farm Show.
Excellent. And the final question I have for you is, what do you see happening in ag in the next 2 years? You know, I'm in the legislature. We hope to be good advocates and strong stakeholders in the work that you do and vice versa. What's top priority for you?
Well, we've got a couple, and it's a great question to ask here at the, you know, the start of a new year, new legislative session, a new term of the governor. I'd say a couple things. One, I think the urban agriculture opportunities, however you want to define that, right? But it's some we've touched on today about, you know, it's the, you know, farm to table, it's Saul High School and ag education, it's workforce, it's the Port of Philadelphia, it's commerce stuff, right? However you want to define that, urban ag becomes really important. The issue of succession planning for the farms in Pennsylvania to make sure that we keep them connected. There are a lot of workforce development issues we want to address to make sure that as we talk about high priority occupations, that agriculture is part of that. I think we can use Saul High School and Lincoln High School and Philadelphia as a great sort of showcase about what's possible in an urban center with evolving needs. So that's what I would see in the next couple of 2 years. Put a real focus on ag as a priority and make a connection between urban and rural. At the nexus there, I think, is where we need to work.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Secretary. It's a real pleasure.
Great to have you. Thank you. Thanks for being here.